All right, guys, welcome to episode number one, Hockey to Hell and Back, the road to recovery. Thank you guys for joining me on this very first episode. If you've listened to Hockey to Heroin, the road to recovery, it's going to be a lot of the same content, same things, same sort of guests, user-friendly name. It was not something that I wanted to do right off the hop, but it's something that was needed. And before I get any further, I want to play this song because I'm going to make a video to this for the next episode. Check this song out. It's written by my buddy Matt. I love this shit. So we're gonna make up a sick intro video to this tune. This guy, listen, this guy made this song. He did all the instruments individually and then put them together in his recording studio. So Matt, man, thank you. I wish I would have had the intro video, but I was spending my time on something a little more important to me that you'll see here shortly. But before I get into anything, I'm going to say that this episode is proudly brought to you by Team Issued Ltd. Team Issued is connecting all walks of life. Team Issued does this by recreating that special feeling of being part of something bigger, a community for all striving towards the same goal. Guys, check them out. Teamissued.ca. Use promo code TOEDRAG15 to get 15% off your total purchase. As always, guys, I'm decked out head to toe. I got the new shipment of Team Issued gear in. I'm loving this crew neck. I got a stack of hats here. We're going to do some giveaways, guys. We'll get to that, but we're going to get into the episode. But like I said, lots the same. Of course, this episode is also proudly brought to you by the Puck Support Foundation, which is very near and dear to my heart. And every episode, of course, is going to be in memory of Matthew Lazinski and all of our other fallen brothers and sisters honestly, guys, the list continues to grow of people we've lost. But the amount of people that reach out to me every single day in the hockey community is, I mean, it's encouraging the fact that they're reaching out. You know what I mean? That's the way that I look at it. Hold on, I like this part. But it's encouraging that they're reaching out. You know what I mean? But it is troubling, and some work needs to be done there, guys. So support the Puck Support Foundation, PuckSupport.com, at Puck Support, and of course, at Puck Support Warriors, our new campaign, which you're going to get to see a little bit about. So bear with me a second, because I'm still figuring out this little video system and I wasn't able to render the video as I wanted to, because as you guys know, with the little baby and everything that's going on, I didn't really have a whole lot of time other than what I was able to get done. But I will say thank you so much to everybody that supported Taylor and I, right from our family members, everybody on social media, like financial donations to us directly, which has been unbelievable because we've needed it. And I felt like a loser about it, and I've been embarrassed about it, but honestly, we've needed it. So thank you. I'm not going to get into it too much right now, but I have mentioned this. I'm going to do something very special. Taylor and I are going to do something very special for everybody once we get Veda out of the hospital. But she is doing very, very, very well. I think Taylor's having a harder time than anybody. She's super tired, you know, running back and forth to the hotel, to the hospital every 3-4 hours. I'm still in Orillia. I'm live from Orillia in the hotel right now, heading back up to Mooresburg. So I'm going to touch on that at the end of the episode about the one-stop skate shop. That's right. Matt Thompson and I are opening up our very own hockey shop, which he's been hard at work while I've been down here. And he's actually a little nervous. I'm not going to lie, guys. He's freaking out. He's had to actually apologize to me 3 times because he's just freaking out. He knows I got my baby down here, but he's put out a lot of money, and he's stressed. He's nervous. But I just keep reminding him there's nothing to be nervous about. We're going to be up there together. My family's going to be up there. We're going to kill it. And we're going to have lots of fun while we do it. And we're going to help people. And I think that's the biggest thing. There's so many different avenues that we're going to be able to branch out from this. And not to mention, Matt's actually so good at sharpening skates now because he's just like that. He's like obsessive compulsive with all that stuff. He's always like telling me, every time he has a new pair up sharpening, he's like, come look how level I got this. I'm like, okay, man, like, I used to leave that to the trainers. Like, I just assumed that my skates were level, but you'd be surprised at how many skates have come in that are off like crazy. Like, I'd never seen anything like it. So, he takes pride in it, and, be sure to visit us up in Morrisburg, Ontario, more on the end of the episode. So seriously, they'll be patient with me for 5 seconds while I figure this out. Obviously you guys know how excited I am about this. The new show. My guest has been, he's joined me before on, you know, my old podcast. And that was like the first time we ever spoke. But since then, our relationship's changed like tenfold. So it's going to be a lot of fun to talk to him. So give me a second while I dial this in, and see if I can figure this out. We'll see you in a few. Guys, let's try this again. Welcome back again to episode 1.5 of Hockey to Hell and back the road to recovery. We're back again for episode number 1. It's good to see you all again. Thanks for all of your patience. I'm going to clip in the audio, but I am going to quickly plug in Team Issued here again. Because Jesse at Team Issued Ltd has been so awesome to me. Shout out to Matt for this sick track. Team Issued, of course, guys, is connecting all walks of life. Team Issued does this by recreating that special feeling of being part of something bigger, a community for all striving towards the same goal. Guys, check it out. Teamissued.ca, promo code TOEDRAG15 to get 15% off your total purchase. I got a box of Team Issued stuff here. If you watched the first 5 minutes earlier, you know that we're going to do another giveaway here. I'm so thrilled to be a part of Team Issued, and more than anything, just have that relationship with the Jess Can again. So that's what we call them when we play together in Kelowna, the Jess Can. That was the soccer ball, the name of the soccer ball we played sewer ball with, but his name was Jess, so we called him the Jess Can. Just how it kind of stuck with him still. So thanks to Jess, guys. Check out teamissued.ca, promo code TOEDRAG15 for 15% off. And I will talk more on the Puck Support Foundation and all that stuff at the end of the podcast, probably throughout too. This is one, guys, I'm so stoked for. This guy's become a friend of mine, and you're going to get to see a little bit of it here. You got to see a little bit of it, but you didn't get to hear it. So let's try this again. We'll see if we can't do this. Maybe I'll take a little extra 2 seconds here to make sure that we're doing it right. Thank you. I just want to say, too, thank you guys so much for all your support. Veda is doing so well. So well. We could not have done it without you guys. I'm serious. It's embarrassing how much we've needed help. Seriously. So thank you. I love it. I love that part. I think I clipped it in there wrong though, like clicks. That's not him. That's me. Rookie mistake again. Let's do it, guys. This is episode 1, back to square 1, but I feel a million miles out of hell. That's how I feel right now. Okay, guys, let's try to do this one more time. No promises that it's going to go super smooth, but I got a better feeling about this one. So let's go. Give me a second here, guys. Okay, guys, give me 1 sec. I do got to figure it out. Honestly, we had it figured out there. And then apparently we didn't. So I'm not going to start it over. I'm going to do it the way that I knew I was going to have to. This sucks. I'm actually so frustrated and pissed off. But this is just, you know, part of it, I guess. This is actually more of a struggle than the very first podcast that I ever did. But it's going to be good. I promise you guys that. I can't wait. I have to wait like 2 minutes. So what I'm going to do, what I can do, guys, is talk a little bit about the things that I'm going to talk about at the end, because we do have 2 minutes. some amazing things have gone on, and I shared this on my social media. So this is a pretty crazy story. So this is where I'm at in my life, where Taylor and I, like, we're at in our lives the last couple weeks. Like, there's been times where literally we have been like, and I'm not saying this to try to get sympathy or anything, because we're good right now. But there's been times over the course of the past few weeks where it's like, man, like, we didn't even know how we were going to have money to eat or whatever, because we're spending money to cabs to get or whatever. And it just seems like every single time when we're just about down and out, we can't figure it out. Some, like, God shot or some, like, I'm not kidding. It's insane. People that I haven't even talked to, all of a sudden it's like, I'll look at my email and it's like, boom, I have like an e-transfer there. I'm like, what? I'm like, this does not happen. Like, this doesn't happen. You know what I mean? And it makes me feel extremely, extremely awkward. It makes me feel embarrassed. But honestly, we could not have done it without so much generosity from so many people. And a family member of mine bought a gift certificate for Taylor and I to go out to a restaurant that's literally directly across the street from the hotel. Okay. So we went out for dinner the other night. Okay. Get this. We went out for dinner and we had the kids with us because they were down for the weekend because Hadley's not in school. So, which was awesome. They came down. We were able to go out for a really nice dinner. The hotel is not the greatest. This restaurant, though, is one of the nicer ones in Orillia. Like, I wouldn't be eating there if I had to go pay for it right now. There's no way. So, what a treat. You know what I mean? I was able to take Taylor and the kids. And so we're sitting there and, you know, Lincoln's only two. So what does a two-year-old do, man? He's motoring around, which is fine. But the people there, like, some people don't like it, but everybody there loved it, man. He's so cute. We had our matching Team Issued hats on. There's pictures. But I had to take him outside for a few minutes just to calm him down, whatever. So anyways, I come back inside. And Taylor's talking to these two older ladies that are just having a glass of wine, eating some appetizers, whatever. And I didn't engage in the conversation at all. It's fine. And then all of a sudden, about 10 minutes later, the waitress comes over and she's like, oh, excuse me, that couple over there, not the old ladies, but a couple sitting across the dining room would like to pay for your guys's meal. What? What do you mean? Why? Why? What? Why do they want to pay for our meal right now? I honestly, looking back at it, I feel so fucking rude right now because I was in shock. I was like, Taylor had tears down her eyes. I had to get up and walk out. And then I felt bad. I actually pretended that I forgot my wallet just so I could go back and thank that couple. Full disclosure, I didn't even tell Taylor that. So, pretty amazing things. When you're doing the right things, when you're really trying hard, I swear to God, good things happen. And the best thing is that I know that Taylor and I, we stay on track. We're going to be that couple giving back to people who need it just like we do right now. And I can't wait for that day. And it's going to be sooner rather than later. So listen, guys, we got about a minute and a half. I know. My guess, listen, if we weren't friends, I would be so fucking nervous. I'm already sweating like crazy. But if we weren't friends, I'd be thinking this guy'd be coming through the fucking screen and grabbing me and being like, listen, kid, fucking, if you're not 15 minutes early, you're 15 minutes late. What the fuck? You know, like, because seriously, like, in the hockey world, man, you're on time. There was a couple times I was late because, you know, I was hungover and seriously, I didn't wake up. But On the regular, I was there every single fuck day early, just like everybody else. And there's really no excuse anywhere to be late. So I appreciate, you know, the patience, not only of him, but all of you guys. Holy shit, I had to start over. But I swear to God, it's going to be worth the wait once we get into this. And once this video actually works, it's going to be, it's cool. It's going to, I don't know. I'm excited about it. I'm excited about this whole experience. I think this is going to open up a lot more doors, dropping the heroin. You know what I mean? It's got a shock value. Like I said, it's going to be my book, but it's kind of run its course in the podcast industry, in my opinion. So here we go, guys. 10 seconds. My guest is got a guest with him, I could see. So 10 seconds, so I can just make sure that this is all good. And like I said, it's now I'm know it's going to work. So take myself out, guys. Enjoy this. And we'll see you in about 11 minutes.
Growing up in and around the area of Vancouver in the early 1990s, it's pretty obvious who my favorite player was growing up. Pavel Bure, the Russian Rocket.
Pavel singularly took the National Hockey League by storm. He was immediately revered by the fans. Nobody had ever seen a player like that. He scored at will.
Times were a little different back then with no YouTube or social media. It took me a little while to find who I really identified with as a hockey player. But as I grew up and developed as a player, pretty soon I found myself wanting to be Darren McCarty. Darren McCarty is the epitome of a Canadian hockey player.
It wasn't until just recently, though, that I actually found out we were born in the same hospital, Burnaby General. But McCarty spent the majority of his childhood in Leamington, Ontario, playing for the South Point Capitals in the OMHA, before joining the Belleville Bulls of the Ontario Hockey League, after dominating Tier 2 Junior.
DMAC played for the Belleville Bulls from 1989 through 1992, captaining the team in the 91-92 season that saw him net 55 goals and adding 72 assists for 127 points in 65 games, leading the way in the Ontario Hockey League. McCarty was drafted in the second round, 49th overall, by the Detroit Red Wings in the 1992 NHL entry draft. DMAC broke into the league and made a name for himself real quick, taking on any opponents, sticking up for his teammates, and becoming a fan favorite overnight. He was on the famed grind line with Chris Draper and Kirk Maltby. I don't need to tell you about March 26, 1997.
Oh, there's another crowd. There's Darren McCarty. Is that Lemieux? Oh, yeah. Here come the goaltenders, and here we go. This is what had to happen. There's nobody there to help out Claude Lemieux. Patrick Waugh came flying out of the...
I was only 9 years old, but I remember it clearly, distinctly, and what I remember is the best hockey game that I have ever witnessed. It is my opinion, and the opinion of many others, that it was that moment that changed everything, not only for Darren McCarty, but for the entire Detroit Red Wings, the city of Detroit, and the entire state of Michigan.
And McCarty went right for Claude Lemieux. It was like a signal. I'm not saying it was intentional, but it just happened that way.
Darren McCarty called Claude Lemieux gutless in one of the Detroit papers today.
After that life-changing night on March 26th, McCarty went on to help Detroit capture three Stanley Cups, including a memorable Stanley Cup game-winning goal in 1997 that was recreated across Canada on front streets, including 1485 Morrison, where I recreated that goal on numerous occasions. It was truly that moment, just like everyone else, I wanted to be Darren McCarty.
Comes back with Neiman in front of him. McCarty draws. McCarty in. McCarty scores! A magnificent goal! Darren McCarty! Trying to get the sweep. 3 seconds left. Into the zone. The Detroit Red Wings on the Stanley Cup. 2 minutes! The
once in a while they go in, I guess. And, you know, they sent me over to Sweden a couple times to work on different things like that. You know, maybe that just came through at the right time. And I'm just happy it contributed in the game. And, you know, we don't do anything easy. They score with 14 seconds left, but that's the way it's been all year. And what a great bunch of guys. You know, Barry Melrose is right when he says losing's the greatest teacher. And winning, it rules, though. Yes. I'm going to go carry the cup.
He captured 3 Stanley Cups before fading away and falling into the pits of his addiction.
Struggle. Rock bottom is not what you hit and then you turn it around. You turn it around when you stop digging. And one of the greatest hockey players and diggers ever has learned that lesson.
But for every battle he has won, there have been others he has lost, with alcohol and gambling, which forced him into rehab, divorce, and bankruptcy, and ultimately to a point where he'd become a shadow of who he once was.
I was sort of lost for about 3 years and hadn't gotten that bad before, to me. And just loathed myself and what I'd become and what I wasn't to the people that I cared about.
But just like the fighter he is, he found the courage to come back. He had a long ways to go and a lot to prove. McCarty started in the old IHL with the Flint Generals.
Right wing making his Flint Generals home debut, number 25.
But it didn't take long before he got the call to the American Hockey League. And once he got there, his instincts took over. In typical DMACC fashion, he recorded a hat trick in his very first game with the Griffins. It didn't take long for the Detroit Red Wings to come calling once again. He would soon once again be in that familiar red and white. This time, it was a little different. His kids were in the stands. D-Mac was a rock star on and off the ice, literally. He was my hero. I even wore number 25 when I played for the Kelowna Rockets in 2007-2008. That Darren McCarty was really struggling, but found the courage to come back and fight once again. Not only did McCarty fight through his own demons, he came back and captured his fourth Stanley Cup championship with the Detroit Red Wings before hanging up the skates for good. It was a pretty special moment. After hanging up the skates, D-Mac has gone on to do many other things away from the rink, including becoming an author, of course a rock star. He's even a stand-up comedian. He also hosts podcasts like Grind Time with Darren McCarty. And he stamped his name in the cannabis industry with his Darren McCarty pre-rolls and his very own vape pens. And he's become a good friend of mine.
About that, Brady Leavold of Hockey to Heroin.
Which has become a dream come true and something that has really changed my life. When I made the decision to put my skates back on again for the first time after 8 years, this was the video message I got from one of my childhood heroes.
Look at you, kid. Back at it, see? Slow and steady wins the race. I'm proud of you, right? Look at the smile on your face. I can see it. It's where you fucking, back where you belong, back where you're born, buddy. But enjoy it. Fucking Snipes, bar down. Come on, bring some off the bar, baby. Fucking high off the glass, just like you were a fucking little kid again, right? It's like I always used to tell Aaron Ward. It's fucking same game as when you're young, guys. You're just bigger and faster, fucking stronger. But barring in is barring in. Way to go, kid. Proud of you. Love you.
It's pretty cool, eh?
D-Mac and I have both had our struggles. Our stories are both very public. I'm not a four-time Stanley Cup champion, but we're both puck support warriors. We both fought battles of our own, on and off the ice. We both fought for teammates on the ice. And now we both want to fight for our teammates off the ice. We've joined together with other former professional hockey players and many other amazing people. We're sick of seeing our brothers and sisters in the hockey community lose their battles. I'm very confident in the Puck Support Foundation, especially with D-Mac on our team. This guy will march 26 you from here to next week, and he'll do the same thing to mental health and addiction. All right, let's do it. Episode 1, Hockey to Hell and Back, the road to recovery with my friend and one of my idols, Darren McCarty. All right, let's...
I got tears in my eyes right now, bro. Just memory lane forever. Yes, I think when we reflect back, you go down memory lane. But more importantly, dude, to see you right now, to hear you talk about Veda, to see where you're at, to see the life back in you. You know, I'm coming up, and this is where. Come here, Royce. Hold on. Dog's whining. Here's where. It's very important where you can see I'm coming up on 5 years on the 11th, right? So 11-11, which is 5 years, which is you understand you're in it now. And everything you said before, about those stories about how you put yourself out there and allow yourself to be helped, right? Because you're going to pay it forward. Right. All that stuff right now. And it just goes to show you that no matter what, if we're in Canada, the United States, North America, wherever we are, right, that you're a human being, the compassion. Like I said, everything I told you, bro, like that. It's all about bar down. Anybody who's ever played hockey or whatever, you could raise the puck. It's all about bar down. It's such an honor to not only you know, I've been your idol, to been your mentor, to see where you're at in life. I'm super proud of you. And what I'm super proud of is because now you've got it to a point, and this is episode number one of to Hockey and Back, right? Because Hockey to Hell and Back, because now, right? And the book is going to be the book, and that's fine. And we all know heroin's part of your story, just like alcohol's part of mine. But you put it where it is, and I love the fact. I'm honored to be the first guest, but it goes more importantly that everybody should see where you're at in your journey, because you're only going to make it stronger. And you only make me stronger, kid, because I got you as this ally, is the stuff that I'm building. And, you know, whether it's Real Darren McCarty brand, what Darren McCarty building, Puck Support Foundation, Brady Leavold, all that. You're my guy, dude. We're born in the same hospital. I mean, Joe Sakic took all the skill, but we got all the toughness. So we're
that's here. Right. Hey, they gotta share some stuff around. Listen, before I say anything, it super sucks that the video wasn't even playing, but I'm gonna make sure that it's posted, because the video that goes with it is actually, it makes it so much better. And I apologize. Like, the reason being is because I actually ran out of room on my little MacBook, and I was trying to delete stuff. I kept trying to render this video, and it wasn't telling me why. Finally, I had to look up the code, and it's like, oh, I don't have just a little bit and not enough space, and then I didn't have enough time to do it. And then it was like, holy, man.
Listen, here's the thing where you realize, and you said it all along, and if anybody was to privy to the conversations as you're trying to get it, you realize, right? If this would have happened when you started the heroin podcast, when you first started podcasting, this would have thrown you way for a loop. What'd you do now? You used every tool in your disposal, and you said, okay, this is what it is. We'll deal with that later. It'll come out the way it's supposed to come out. The bottom line is you and I are connected for conversation, where we're at, and what happened? Life happened, bro. Life happened right when we're trying to do something. But you know what? That's just part of it, that we're just going to ebb and flow with it. And that's why I'm proud of you. I see that. And I watch you go through it and text me and all this. And I'm just sitting here laughing. And I go, I remember being there. So you're doing a great job, kid.
Just I know. I'm sitting here. I'm in the corner of the fucking hotel. Like, Taylor's up there in the NICU. It's like, but you know what? We're doing so well. And the reason being is because we have so much support. And the support from you, man. Like, I know you said some things, but like, it was said in the video, man. But like, seriously. And there's a lot of us, not just me, that have looked to you. Like, you know how many people like think it's so cool that I talked to Darren McCarty? Like, I know you must, like, you're just Darren McCarty, but like, you know the effect that, you know, you've had in that generation, right? And as hockey players. So, you know, I it's such an honor, man. And like, you know, like at the beginning of that video, like, sure, I grew up in Vancouver. Everybody loved Pavel Bure. I wanted to be Pavel Bure, but soon I was never gonna be Pavel Bure. I almost could have been you. I couldn't be you, but I was going to be closer to being you than Patrick Bure. But at the same time, what I've realized is like, there's very few Pavel Bures, but there's very, very, very few guys that played the game as hard and as well as you did, D-Mac. The whole spectrum of the game. And that's why I migrated to you at such a young age. And I'll tell you, I didn't include it in the video. I actually won 50 or 100 bucks off that goal. I remembered. Because my dad's, I'll just say friend, because I don't want to get him in trouble. It was an ex-girlfriend, but I guess I got him in trouble. He was a huge, huge fire check. He loved Eric Lindros and all them and all this stuff. So do you know how much, like, I just loved it. I got the broom out. I was sweeping the whole thing, 9, 10 years old. So, man, thanks, man. I think I got, like, candy and a new hockey or something. So
I love it. Hey, and you know what, Brady, I want to let me, before we start talking, to your point about just opening up the skate shop and all that stuff. And you know how important you and I are the same. The trainer's in charge of that, whatever, like the skates and stuff like that. That was never my forte. I just assumed. But guys, I'm telling you out there, kids, parents, whatever, even if you're playing and even if you're an adult league guy, if you go to the proper place to begin with to always get your skates done the proper way by somebody, it's not only the equipment, it's stuff like that. I grew up with the sport. If I didn't have the sports store and the relationship in minor hockey that I did, I'm going through sticks. They used to buy me 2 dozen Canadians at a time because my dad could get them for $5 each. And I'd snap like 2 a game. Right. Yeah. But it was like, you need those. So it's imperative that local relationship that people getting into the sport or into the sport have. So not only is it a place to go and talk hockey, it's a place to go and be instructed about the proper equipment, the proper lie to your stick. No one ever talks about that. We're kids. What is the lie to your stick? It's when you put your stick on the ice. Is it sit flatter? Is the toe in the air or the heel in the air? All those little things. So you'll be able, and that's your passion. Just like Taylor, it's awesome.
It's kind of funny, right? Because like Matt played like junior and stuff, and he owns a senior team actually that I'm playing on. Like, you know, I made the comeback. So he actually owns a team too. Like that's the guy who told me the story about Matthew Lazinski, the guy who passed away from the overdose of OHL. This is his friend. So me and him have become best friends, me and this Matt guy. So anyways, but like, you know, I'm doing all the, you know, I'm kind of a techie. It didn't look like it at the beginning of this, but I'm, you know, I do editing and stuff like this. I like it. So that's kind of where I'm in. And I do the digital, I'm setting up the iPad with the point of sale and all that. So he's freaking out because he doesn't know how to do any of that. But I remember I put on one of the pictures, it's like, you know, come see the pros. And he read it. He's like, man, I'm just learning how to sharpen skates. I'm like, well, for one, you keep turning out perfect skates every time. And two, I played professional hockey and I'm going to be there. So come see the pros. Like, he's like, I never thought of that. I'm like, exactly. And we know enough guys that, you know, can come, you know, we'll do a little event, sign autographs or whatever. And like, you should see the place. Like on the next episode, I'll have the pictures up, but like it's just a little place, but it has a shop door. So in the summertime, we can open that up and have a little,
you know, street. It's, you know, gonna be how awesome. Important that is.
Yes.
How important that Absolutely. Is for me. because Darren McCarty, right? So Darren McCarty, the fact that for the kid that the adult that won all the cups, well, the kid had to start somewhere, and it's the community, and you want to build the community or where to go. And when you always come back to who are the guys, you know, the old man Brooks was our guy at the skate sharp.
Yeah.
He was probably like 80 years old, but dude, you anything you needed, you'd always go into the guy. So that's why I think it's imperative. And it doesn't matter what level you play. You love hockey, you know, you need a place to go to chirp the Leafs, you know?
Yeah. And we already, Matt's already showed me, he had me on video. He's like, yeah, man, look, this is where the TV is going to go. We'll have the PlayStation set up. Like once COVID calms down, if it does, you know, kids can come in there, play PlayStation. I envision having like a, you know, like one of those light up shooting target places where kids whatever, just to get people in there. And like you said, I never really thought of it as much as the point you brought up, but I'm glad that you you gave a shout out to your local old sports shop, and I'll do the same, because I had the same thing in Port Coquitlam. There was this place called M&R Sports, and it was ran and owned by a guy named Mike Bowen, who I believe is still sharpening skates out of Planet Ice in Coquitlam. I think it's Rocket Rod Skate Shop. I don't know if he owns it, but this guy, I'm telling you, I would not go anywhere to get my skate sharpened. I used to ride my bike downtown to my small town after school just to get my skate sharpened by this guy, and would come back every summer. So what a great point, man. And I'm sure everybody listening played. We all had that. And if you didn't, and if you don't, that's kind of sad. And I'm glad that Matt and I will be able to bring that to the Morrisburg area for sure. D-Mac, thanks for bringing that up.
Man. That's, I think that's the, that's, you know, that's what, you know, the bottom line is, one of the loves that we all share, usually, like not only the passion of life and, you know, survive and grinding through life and stuff like that, but it's also the enjoyment of it. What is your passion? You know, all that stuff. You know, you mentioned wearing the hat, the Darren McCarty brand, where I'm able to create, the cannabis that has saved my life for people who that are out, you know, have alcoholism or insomnia and stuff like that. And the biggest thing, which will be coming e-commerce, which means everywhere, is I have a CBD roll-on being released at the end of November. So that's the, to me, that's where it's at, because it's the education of your appetite, your sleep, your pain, you know, your body, and it's all about, what do you mean by that? Instead of arguing. So
that's right,
putting,
man,
people
that's
on their own journey. We've talked about it, and you know, and here's a great for people to know, because if they come and they're seeing the Darren McCarty, Brady Leavold on the screen, well, there's 11 rehabs between these two guys, right? There's one on the left that has can tell you everything about heroin. There's one on the right can tell you everything about alcohol. And what you're gonna run into are the ups and downs. So we got that covered, and it's one of these things is why, you know, you mentioned I wrote my book 8 years ago, My Last Fight, True Story of a Hockey Rockstar. And even 8 years ago, like I said, I'm coming up on 5 years sobriety. Even in the book, I was still drinking, but trying to cut in my search to get there. Now 5 years coming up on being sober, it's such a different place, but it's okay. You know, and it's the understanding of that understanding who I am and who I want to be to myself, not to everybody else. Right. And unfortunately, a lot of us get caught up in that. And you know what? We're just sick. And so Puck Support Foundation, get a hold of us. It's for male, female, anybody with the love of the hockey. You know, we're here, it's all that. So that's the whole reason why we're connected. And then our story goes even tighter, because all people need to know is that we're born in the same hospital. That's all you got. That's like when you say cannabis and I say endocannabinoid system. We all have one for this plant specifically. That's the common sense, you know, so.
And that's the thing. A lot of people don't know. And the thing that I like that you mentioned, and I haven't thought too much about this, if at all, is that it's interesting. You know, you said the guy on the left can tell you about heroin. The guy on the right could tell you about alcohol. And then, you know, you have these people that want to argue. And it seems to me that the people that want to argue against us have no experience with the things that we're dealing with.
Well, Brady, you know, you, this is, and here's the lesson that you'll have to learn, right? Because you and I, we could go to the dark. Like, we're two people that could go, oh yeah, well, oh, I remember I this, and it's like not a one up thing. It's like been there, right? So yeah. The fact that if I'm gonna learn experience from somebody, I want to hear. I'm gonna listen to the person that has read the book, and I'm gonna listen to the person that has lived the movie, right? More times than not, the person that's lived the movie, you know, because they've been there, than not, they didn't get it out of the book, they didn't go to school for it, whatever. They've lived it because life, it ain't this way. Now, what I try to do is I just try to say, hey, I've been there. This is what happens. What I had to realize is that if I do certain things, hence, if I drink, I die. It's as simple as that. Now, everybody thinks that, oh, wow. Like I said, don't worry about it. I didn't say that I'm a diabetic and I'm allergic to chocolate. I mean, that'd be even worse. That'd ruin my edible buzz. But it's alcohol. So I figured it out. It took me 25 years or so, bro, to figure out that alcohol, I die. So I just was able to get to a point to eliminate it. Now, with my education, like I say, I live by the principles of AA. I've been to more AA meetings than whatever. I love the concept, but that's 1920, 1930. That's not the way it is. And
right.
I say I live by the principles of AA, but my program has a garden. And that's, you know, so for there's other people that want to live life and be good people. And I always say it's about your pure, as long as you have pure intentions, we can get through everything, because then I know that it wasn't done maliciously, or, you know, the people make mistakes and we work through them. And you and I are the epitome of what happened is we got tired of, we realized that we're going to get back up. So why keep throwing ourselves on the ground? Right. Let's just go on a different path. Been there, done that. Let's try something, you know, let's do the normal thing. And, you know, let's raise kids and yeah. grind it out and have real life conversations and try to help people. Because I know that talking to you, you know, because of our connection and just little things like the clip, it puts into perspective. Because yeah, I'm Darren McCarty, but life happens for me too. I'm having, like, I needed this because I've had a tough couple of days. Just, it's been a grind mentally more than anything. Usually it's not, but I'm aware that it is. So to be able to have this conversation at this time, like you said, it's a God shot, and it's the ability to receive the message of what's out there. And I mean, I got the resume. You look at the way that things have played out in my career, the fact that I'm still here, you're still here. Now it's time to do something that we can be proud of.
Yeah. Oh, and before I say anything, there was a time I was talking to with PJ Stock there on episode 62. That's right. And I didn't get your message till after. But I was telling a story about, you know, and then I forgot. And I wanted to mention this. And I don't know if I, you know, just share this or whatever, but there's a, you know, I won't go into detail, but there's essentially a group that, you know, that you started, and it's pretty much all guys that played like 500 plus games in the show, and, you know, a chat, and just, you know, here and there, little messages, checking in on guys. And you brought me into that group, you know what I mean? And so after that, you know, I was able to connect with guys like Brad May and Todd Bertuzzi and a couple other guys. You know, growing up in Vancouver with Todd, you know, he was one of the guys too, right? And so it was, you know what I mean, for you to do that for me, you know what I mean, just to bring me into that group, and whether I should share that or not, but it's, you know, it's just there's a few guys just to say, hey, you know what, we're all here, whatever. And I noticed that I'm in this group and I'm like, okay, because I had a few of the numbers, right? There's like whatever, a few of these numbers. I had a few of them in my phone, and then all of a sudden names start popping. I'm like, holy shit. I'm like, I'm like the only guy in here that didn't play in the NHL, like, and isn't like a legend of some sort. And you know what I mean? So Darren, what you did for me there, and like there, and the reason why I'm telling this story is because there was a time when I was riding on the train up to Ottawa, or maybe I was coming back, I can't remember, but I was having a really, really hard time. And I had reached out to Todd and talked to him briefly, but he, you know, I hadn't talked to him in like a couple of weeks. And all of a sudden I was sitting there, man, I was almost in tears. Okay. Like just so stressed out about everything that was going on about having this kid, not having money. Everything. And all of a sudden I had my AirPods in and I'm sitting there like almost in tears. And like Siri comes on. It's like Todd Bertuzzi says, "Hey bro, just checking in on you. Just want to see how you're doing." And I'm like, you know what I mean? Like in my AirPods. And I'm like, holy shit. I'm like, that's pretty fucking cool. You know what I mean? Like, and then I almost started to cry more because it's like, you know, this is, that's pretty awesome. And that's because of you, you know what I mean? And so I have that with, not just with you, but with, and not just NHL superstars. There's such a community of people that you know, want to do good and help each other. And we've all had different, you know, whether it's struggles with addiction or in life or whatever, everybody has that, right? And sometimes, you know, it just takes for a guy like me, especially like, you know, as a hockey player, to be able to have that support, especially from you, man. And then like the secondary coming from Todd, all that. It makes me like, there's no fucking way I can screw up, man. There's just no way. You know what I mean?
Well, and here's the thing, Brady. So you have to understand, and this is for all the listeners to understand, that there's always because you see the responsibility that I put in you where, and it's the fact of because you could handle the responsibility, because here's the thing, right? Organization and communication is the best thing. There's different levels, right? So if you are passionate and with the Puck Support Foundation, everything that you do, and you're out doing your thing, well, I need to know that. So that, and it's not just me. It's to let you know that what you're doing affects guys that you idolize or that are the show guy, because we're all the same. We're all hockey guys. And what in this future, as we're trying to put different things together, it's not about the what, it's about the who. And the levels don't matter, because it's the communication and it's the fact that I see you, I care, you know, and it's the person that I've never met yet, I care about them if they want to be better than where they're at. I always say, listen, it's like mortal engines. I'm out here shining the light. If you're in the dark, come on to the light. But you don't bring your dark. You try to bring that dark on the into the light, and it's not me. You know, like we don't do that. You're off on your own. It's what I tell everybody else. I do not care what you do. If I'm not doing it, though, don't do it around me.
That's right.
Right? That's the whole thing. So in saying that, there's more guys out there. And this comes with the responsibility of guys that care. And you mentioned, you know, a guy, you said like 500 games, whatever. Most of the guys that did it are the guys that are the tough guys, and the guys, you know, like the Scott Parkers, you know, the Scott Thorntons, you know, the Bertuzzi, the guys that there's a love of their fellow players that played that way. And you know that. And going through a lot of struggle. So everybody, you know, everybody's got their own demons, but the fact that it's bringing the locker room and you're wearing your team issued and whatever red it is, white. It's about red team. And red and white, baby, because it's, you know, it's that one thing that we're all in this together, no matter what it is. And life's going to happen, right? Like you're going to get, everybody's going to get frustrated. You're going to want to throw that computer more than once a day. You're going to, but what you're able to do is you're able to prioritize and put things into perspective more of what's important. And where you realize, you know, now Veda, who's, you know, still in the hospital and being, but you're there, you're present, you're being the best you can be. And even doing that, it's just that self-awareness. Like I always say, is that here's the biggest trick I can say. When you walk by the mirror, I don't care who you lie to, but if you look yourself in the mirror, don't lie to that person. Good, bad, or indifferent. My story is I used to walk by, I wouldn't look, and then I looked one day and I said, I'm not feeling right now. And he looked back at me and said, hope you're alive and come back. And I was like, man, this guy's swarmy. So then I started talking to him and I was like, oh, he's cooler than most of the people I hang out with. But in saying that, it was like knowing what, just what is it that you want? Who are you? And for all of, for hockey guys, hockey people, it's a team, right? I'm no good. I'm meek, man. I want to win, not for myself. I would have played golf or tennis, you know, if you're individual, but I want to win for the team, because winning four cups, it's all about the stories. And it's all about, to this day, even 23 years later from the first one, is that I got a thread with all the guys that I can chirp, whoever, who you want me to chirp right now. Shanny? Yeah, Shanny. Nice job. right? Like, there you go. Like, so, but that's what it's all about, bro. It's about, because that's the love. That's the little kids in us. That's the love of the room. You mentioned the Jess can, you know, yeah. You know, like, I mean, that's things that he'll never shake, you know, because yeah. that, how bad is he in that game? Wow. He had to be really bad. He had to be like D-Mac then.
He was so bad, man. He was 16. He was probably the worst on the team, but he always played. He was a good sport. He was always like the first out, never complained, always had a smile on his face. And that's what I mean. It was so great to be able to connect with, you know what it's like to be able to reconnect with some of these guys, man. It's unreal.
And right. And so that's sort of what you've taken on, sort of the responsibility just of, you know, getting guys out there. I noticed Dodie Wood, right? There's a tough little cracker back in the day, man. That way, but there's a guy who also has a story, and the fact that to everybody can reach out in different spots and wherever it is, it's just sort of waving a bunch of different flags. So if we're just, so instead of waving one and one here, one there, there's flags all over the place because it's your brotherhood and your sisterhood.
Right. Yeah. It's unbelievable. And two, I'm going to say, I'm glad you said sisterhood. I haven't told anybody this, actually anybody except for her that she knows. Jacqueline Hawkins is going to join me, and she's, I'm not going to get into too much about her story, but she's a really prominent woman in the hockey industry, and she's going to be my second guest. So, I had a couple females on before, but that's something that I think is really important, that I want to reach out more to the female listenership, especially the players. There's been a few, especially that's all right, man. That's part of it.
Well, here's if you can hear the dog. So I got two Yorkies, right? They're like 8 and 9 years old, and Yorkies are like, stop.
I had a Yorkie too, and I got a Chihuahua. So, buddy, I know what it's like. Taylor usually has to, I have to go lock myself in rooms and trailers and all over the place to get away from the dogs. We have so many dogs, so I'm used to it, man. But, you know, I'm really trying to reach out to the female listenership, because what I've come to realize too is, like, actually, female NCAA women's hockey actually has the second highest rate. The second highest rate for concussion.
Yeah, there it is.
That's all right. No, yeah, second highest rate for concussions for women. That's a big one. And this is one that's getting more attention, as I've been able to unfortunately uncover a few females that are, you know, have struggled and lost their battle as well, and some that are still struggling. And again, it's far reaching too, because I know you're involved with Athletes for Care a little bit too. And I've been talking to Riley and getting involved there too. I mean, there's the community of sport. It really is something special. But I think, you know, with yourself and me, like our focus, I feel like my focus has to be within the hockey community. I will always do what I can for everybody. But right now, man, like, hockey has saved my life.
But here's the thing, right? So what I would encourage you to do is to dig more into that side of it, the NCAA, the women's side, the stuff like that, my point, what I was saying as far as how you support me, because the more legwork that you do to find all this stuff out, right? Because you bring it to me and then we can tackle it right there, right? Instead of somebody having to navigate through the mess, we get things done. And it's about people, if they're watching this or they hear this or whatever like that, it's just reaching out to @realDarrenMcCarty, DarrenMcCarty.com, or reaching out to Hell and Back. What's it called again? I got to get this down.
Hockey to Hell and Back.
Hockey to Hell and Back. Road to Recovery, right?
Yeah, well, I don't know if I'm going to keep the Road to Recovery. I just throw it in there. I like the Hockey to Hell and Back. It's a little more simple, but yeah, the name
you'll,
is...
You'll figure it out. You'll figure it out, and I'll remember it. It doesn't matter. Yeah.
We'll figure it out as we go, I'm sure.
But that's that's what I encourage everybody else. What is it, like you said, that is your passion. That is just, so I want you to dig deep into the hockey circle so everything else, you know what I'm saying? Everything else filters through and we, you know, things can help. You got to look at, so how long ago, because I don't even know, November. So when was it, when did we talk on your other podcast or when did we connect? Before COVID?
Yeah, just after, because I started
after COVID.
Just after, like maybe a month or two into COVID, I would say like May, maybe mid-May.
So it's safe to say that this is 6 months.
Yeah, right? Give or take.
This is your journey, right? Okay. So you understand the, like, because now you're not only with the computer, with all the this different stuff that you're finding your groove, right? And that's the groove. It doesn't matter what Brady's groove is. Darren's got to do his groove. And it's about the collection of the group, right? The team. There's no numbers. You know, there's no maximum number of participants. There's no, right? That's the beauty of it. It's starting that conversation. And it doesn't matter, like you said, if it's specifically heroin or alcohol, that's fine. But there's other things that people need to talk about, mental health issues, you know, sleep, pain, all this different stuff that we can talk about. You know, people are kind of curious. What is all this about? Well, you need a place to go and ask those questions where you don't feel like you're stupid or looked down on or something else, because there's something to it. It's about the option, right? It's about the option of where you're going to get your information and who you're going to trust. So in my world, like you said, why wouldn't hockey people trust hockey people?
That's right.
That's all it is. And then it just elevates that way.
Where are we at? Then where are we at with your e-com? When you say e-commerce, for
that it can be sold everywhere, because
doesn't matter. No, Canada, U.S., all
Canada,
that.
U.S., China, yes. Japan, that's, everywhere. So
that's awesome.
Right. So, because here's the thing, the education, right? We're in the U.S., because of the 0.3, where it's allowed to have the CBD, it's regulated by the FDA, which is a food and drug, right? So that means it can be sold everywhere, which is huge. So you'll have one as soon as they come out. And it's, I can't be more excited and more honored. It's taken 2 years to develop. We use Madagascar vanilla, which is the most expensive vanilla on the planet. The scent of it, the effect of it, like the instant relief, like usually with a topical or a hemp or a roll-on, right? It's one of these things that you'd say, hey, you feel anything? No, no. And then 10 minutes later, you're like, oh, how's your knee? And you're like, oh, it doesn't hurt. This one, mine, this one, you rub that thing on and you can feel it sort of. It has that more effect. As a hockey player, when I put on Flexol or when I got legs or whatever, I wanted to feel some activation. So this has some activation feeling.
Right.
Where
I like that.
Right. Yeah. And the smell is so good. It's like, you know, when you go in to get a professional massage and that the way that room smells, and it's just so like puts you in that zen. That's sort of the smell. So, nice. You know, and again, so my passion, like you said, is with the plant and is protecting the plant and protecting everybody who wants to get their own education and make their own decision on if this is for them or not, right? Because I, you know, it's not about whether you do or you don't. It's to know that you have an option.
Yeah, my buddy Phil there says, thanks, D-Mac, for the RSO recommendation. Is that what it is?
RSO, Rick Simpson oil. So Rick Simpson oil, which is he's a Canadian, and he deserves the, I don't know what it is in Canada, but whatever the Congressional Medal of Honor is, because pretty much he figured out a way to take the whole plant and compress all the cannabis components and extract it into a tar, which is used to kill cancer. And that's 8 days of that is what I detoxed on to get the physical addiction to alcohol out of my system. So I encourage anybody who's going through or has any family members to look seriously into RSO, Rick Simpson oil, because it is the lifesaver. And thank you, Phil. Tell your friends.
Wow. Yeah, that's something that, you know, I don't know too much about that I'm going to have to look more into, not only for me, but there's a couple people in my life that I think could definitely benefit from that. And I just think that's a thing, right? There is so much out there, you know, with everything. I mean, there's good and the bad, but I think, like we've talked about before on the other podcast, you know, we grew up in this era where this cannabis industry gets a bad name, when in fact it's so beneficial when used in the proper ways. And there's so many products like the topicals that a lot of people don't even know that stuff exists, to be honest, right? Like, right. It's just sort of coming to fruition now. So it seems to me like you're kind of getting on top of the market, and this could really be a good thing, especially for the hockey community, man. And like, I don't know, like, so I made a post on my Instagram. I don't know if you saw this, and I almost didn't make it because I didn't know how true it was. I seriously just stole it from somebody. So I don't, maybe, but I'm trusting that it's true. And it's a quote from Connor McDavid that says something like, you know, you'd have to be stupid to not look into the cannabis industry, at least, like something along those lines. Like, you'd have to be stupid to at least not open your eyes to it, is what he's saying. Like, when you have Connor McDavid saying that.
Well, here's the thing, Brad. Here's the thing, what you want to talk about millennials or whatever the generation is, the greatest gift that they've given, in my opinion, is transparency on anything. It has to be true. You know, the internet's given that. We grew up in a different time. You know, we grew up in Reefer Madness. I grew up in Reefer Madness area where you're either a jock or you're a stoner. I didn't smoke till after I had sport hernia surgery, and I couldn't handle the Percocet and the Vicodin and all those pills that they gave me. I hated it, and I went to cannabis, and my body went, it was like light bulb. It's like, wait, what? Why is this? I could sleep. I could, you know, and then, so that started me on that, to say the point that shows you how I guess alert or Connor McDavid is, not only, you know, one of the faces of the league, but he's also conscious socially, you know, and understands that you have to look into it. And here's the thing: when you look into it, all you do is find benefits, because the studies are out, the money's been put into it. It's one of these things, when you want to, and I look at it that way. I know now, with all the information that I know, is when you want to look for it to be a positive, it will be a positive, right? The beneficial. Somebody asked me this yesterday about the NHL and whether, you know, what do I think about them? You know, are they going to allow kids? And I said, I don't care. I said, that's the billion-dollar machine that I don't care about. What I care about is that the player that's struggling, that I find out, that knows that hey, you got somewhere to go, or you got answers outside of the system. You know, we're going to operate this thing the way that, getting back to, you know, our text message and whatever it is, you know, the old gray balls, the old saggy balls guys or whatever, we're going to do it our way. We don't care, you know, like the way that it's supposed to be done, because it's obviously we've lost too many people and stuff like that. So the way that it's going to be done is the way that we want it. And I don't care about if the NHL ever changes. They should. I mean, I care for the fact that they're dumb and it costs them in the long run, because if they don't even educate on the CBDs and all the different stuff, but it's coming that way because, you know, Canada's already there. United States, who knows what the hell they're doing, but it doesn't matter. The consciousness is there. And I think, to your point, to answer your question, the fact that one of the best players in the league says that, then that lets me know that we're closer to something happening, because he's just not going to come out and say that, you know, like if it was when we played, somebody's saying, well, we didn't have Instagram, but thank God. Because then you know who I am. Then you just saw my highlight reel. But you know what I mean? It's because it's right and it's true, and everybody knows that, whether they're going to admit it or not, they see it and they realize it, and they see it in people like me. November 11th, which is in a week, it will be my 5 year. And what I asked for, my wife's been doing it every year. She'll do a collage of 2015, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 2020 on each day of to see where I've come. And you can't argue this plant, bro. You can't argue this plant, because that's exactly, if it's golf as much as I can and get as much cannabis into my body. But the thing is I know what my body needs. I know how, what specific strains, what specific topical or CBD gummy that I need to operate throughout the day. And that's just an education that I think that everybody deserves, if they want to understand. So that's my mission, just to answer, what do you mean by that?
That's awesome, man. That's your birthday there, November 11th. That's actually Matt Thompson's real birthday too. My buddy there at the One Stop Skate Shop. So that's his birthday.
He's gonna be right on.
His 33rd birthday on the same day you're celebrating. So it'll be a pretty cool day, man. That's awesome, bro. Like, congratulations. Listen, we'll wrap this up, but I'm sure you're gonna join me again. And
absolutely.
I know your time's super valuable, and like, you had to fuck wait around for me for 45 minutes while I try to figure out a video that still never worked. But yeah, at least got to hear the audio. So, anyways, I'll make sure I'll send you over the video, because honestly, I think you'll want to see it. It's kind of cool. The actual video that I post to YouTube will have the full thing. So just the people that unfortunately had to watch it live will ever see the butchered version. Buddy, listen, man, I so appreciate everything you've done, not only for me, but the hockey community. And you already know you have my 100% support. Not that you need it, but anything. Anything I can do, and as soon as you can ship to Canada, you let me know. And where the hell's my visor anyways?
It's coming, bro. You know, like, here's the thing, right? I have to listen. I get like two things at once, right? Like all this stuff, because it goes so fast, so it's got to be privied out. So when I get, I already had two of these, but I'll get you one.
All right. Well,
I'm going to tell Nick. That means, show me your flow again. Take that hat off, because that flow is looking sick, dude.
Yeah, I'm growing it out, man. It
looks good. See, so I'm gonna send you out the visor and the CBD roll on at the same time, bro.
Yeah, and I'm gonna send you a team issued hat for sure. But we got some puck support clothing coming soon, and like, we got this new campaign rolling out for the puck support warriors, which you're right on. Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. It's going to be a lot of fun, man. Pending COVID, hopefully we can get some events wherever they may be. And one day we can actually shoot the shit in person. I can't wait for that. We can smoke a joint and fucking hang out and laugh and whatever else. And
exactly.
Tell some dumb, stupid stories that we've done. I can't wait, man.
You got it, buddy. Anytime, you keep doing what you're doing. You, take care of that baby and your girl and all the rest of those little rugrats running around, and keep doing what you're doing, bro. You know, I'm here for you. So whatever you need.
That means so much to me, brother. And I'm here for you too. Anything. I mean, I'm not sure I can do much right now, but you know, I'm here too, man. And I love you, brother. Seriously. You have no idea how much I appreciate your friendship. It means the world to me, man. What an honor.
My man. You bet. Love you too.
You're the man, bro. We'll talk soon. Guys, that's episode one. It was like three episodes in one if you had watched it live. I'm sorry, guys. Fucking awesome. Trying to lose the F-bombs, but fuck, who cares? That was fucking awesome. Shitty beginning. Terrible technology in the beginning. I was pissed. Texting D-Mac. I was like, I'm going to fucking throw my computer against the wall. Texting Taylor, I was fucking choked, because I worked so hard on this video and had it all ready, and then of course I didn't. But if you're not watching live, you have no fucking idea what I'm talking about. So anyways, thank you so much for watching That was a blast for me. I hope you guys had fun. I look forward to doing this lots every Wednesday and Saturday. The dates may change, but right now, Wednesdays and Saturdays, Hockey to Hell and Back, The Road to Recovery. Saturday, Jacqueline Hawkins joins me. If you don't know who she is, Google her. I'm going to have some information on her coming. Woman's hockey life. That's all you need to know. This woman is really leading the charge for ladies out there, and I can't wait to talk to her, and she could tell us all about what she's doing. She's been featured in the hockey news and all sorts of things, and was a professional woman hockey player herself. So guys, can't wait. What else is going on? What isn't going on? Matt, if you're watching, if you're listening, bud, get some sleep. I'll be there Friday. It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. The one-stop skate shop will be open for business. And Darren McCarty made such an excellent point. I am so freaking excited to have a spot for the local people to come to. Come say hi. If you're traveling through, come say hi. We could teach kids how to shoot. We could teach them how to dangle. Maybe they could teach me. Some of these kids these days are pretty unbelievable. I cannot wait, although I'm a little bit nervous because I don't know where my family's going to live, but I know everything's going to work out. It has to work out. It can't not work out. That's where my mentality is at right now. I'm so grateful. I'm so lucky. I'm not sure I deserve all of this, you guys. I know Taylor and Veda do, though. I know Hadley and Lincoln do. I know Brooklyn and Brody do. If you notice in the picture, too, I'll say, I don't know if anybody picked up on it. In the picture, Hockey to Hell and Back, there's a logo on the sticks there. If you see where it says Leavold. If you look closely, you may be able to look and see that my kids' names are, in fact, on those sticks. So, all of my kids' names. So, check it out if you want. Before I go, I just really want to say what a privilege and an honor this is to be able to do this and actually have people listen, to have people reach out, to ask me for advice, which sometimes I can give and sometimes I just don't have the answers, but I always try to do my best. I get behind on messages. I feel horrible sometimes. Sometimes it takes me a couple days because I get so many and I'm learning and I'm trying to manage my time. I'm just so lucky, man. Like, I really have been to hell. I was in hell for a long time. Since I was 5 years old, I was living in some form of hell. It progressively got worse. I didn't think I was going to make it out. I seriously had given up. I told you guys this. But I'm back. There's no going back to hell. There's no need for it. I don't need to live there anymore. That feels pretty amazing. I'm so lucky to have Taylor and all the kids. I'm lucky to have an opportunity to get Brooklyn and Brody back in my life and hopefully meet my one son that I've never met. But It's been a struggle, you guys. Like, I don't know. What a cool experience. I just got to talk to one of my idols again. I talk to him all the time, but Taylor cut these gloves that I bought from the dollar store for wristbands because D-Mac wears red wristbands all the time. So this was a little shout out to him. And of course the red team issued hoodie. Before I go, as promised, let's give away some team issued gear. Let's do it. You guys bared with me. Anybody want to win some free team issued gear? I only get some comments, so I'm sorry. Some of the comments pop up, some of them don't. So this is how we're gonna do it right now. Whoever's watching live, if you're listening to audio, please don't participate in this. I'm sorry, but I guess you'll just have to check out live. And before I do, I see a comment just come in from Nick Young. Shout out to Mike. He always helped me out at Planet Ice 2. Nick, you're so young, you probably never even saw M&R Sports, which was right beside the underpass on Shaughnessy coming towards Earl's. Like, if you're going towards Safeway, before you come under the underpass, it would be on your left-hand side. It's like the Terry Fox Foundation. I don't know what's there now, but that's what it was. M&R Sports Shop. Mike Bowen, the best skate sharpener I ever had. So shout outs to him. Thanks, Mike. Here we go. So listen, you want to win, you got to watch live. That's what I said. I'm sorry if you're listening to the audio. The first person to answer this question, and I'm going to tell you how you have to answer this question, is going to win a team issued face shield. Just like this. That's all I'm going to give away right now because I got to wrap this up and go see my baby girl. But I have one brand new in the package. This is mine. You're not getting this one. I was actually had it on. I seen D-Mac had one of these on too. And I usually always have this on since I got this. As soon as I wake up in the morning, this goes on and doesn't come off. The only reason I took taking it off was because I put the red hoodie on and it came flying off. I like the backwards. Okay, so here we go. Who can answer this question? Okay. On what? I was going to make that a really hard question, but you would have had to listen to the beginning and remembered. So I'll backtrack. The very first person to answer this question will win the face shield. Here we go. Ready? What is my girlfriend's last name? Call my cell phone 705-205-5123. 705-5123. Anybody watching want to win a face shield? What is my girlfriend's last name? Call my cell phone 705-205-5123. If nobody wants to win, oh, we got a call. Hello? Hold on one sec. Hello? Are you there?
I'm there, pal.
What's going on, Phil?
What are you doing?
Just doing a little podcast, buddy. Were you watching?
Oh, yeah, I was watching.
You're watching right now. What's my girlfriend's last name, man?
Devitt.
Phil, you're the winner. You have won.
I'm the winner.
You're the winner. Team issued face shield. Thanks for watching, man. Hey, man, listen, You thanks so much, Abe, for all your support. I seriously, truly appreciate it, man.
No problem, pal. Anytime. I'm there for you whenever you need. I know what life struggles are. You know, I know a lot of hockey guys do, pal. So keep going. Keep fighting for this fight.
All right, buddy. Okay, Phil.
See you, Tom.
We'll talk soon, man. Send me your address.
I will. Cheers, pal.
Talk soon.
Bye.
All right. That's Phil Myaskowski. He's the winner of a team-issued face shield protecting you from COVID-19. Kent? There we go. Teamissued.ca, promo code TOEDRAG15 for 15% off. Check out the Puck Support Foundation, PuckSupport.com, at Puck Support, at Puck Support Warriors. That is where we're going to give away some team issued gear tonight. Follow at Puck Support Warriors on Instagram, or as the kids call it, the IG. Also, our very first youth Puck Support Warrior Ambassador is being named very shortly. Again, I thought it would have been done, but running out of time. But this little Puck Support Warrior is somebody very dear to my heart, somebody that I would have no problem investing many hours teaching him anything he wants to know about hockey or life. Because not only him, but his family are first-class people. Can't wait to announce that, guys. Thank you so much for all your support. It means the world to Taylor and I. I don't think Taylor's last name is going to be Devitt for too much longer. I heard some guy might ask her to marry him at some point. I don't know who that is, but could happen. I certainly don't think that guy has a ring or the money for it, but I think he might want to at some point. That's what he told me anyway. So we'll see. Taylor, good luck with that. I think the chances are pretty good. Pretty good. Yeah. Anyways, guys, I love you lots. Thank you so much for listening. Sorry if you made a comment and I didn't see it. It doesn't all post. I saw quickly Sandra Murray was watching. Sandra, we love you. Reach out to Sandra. Sandra at PuckSupport.com. If you're struggling, guys, Sandra, you're such an amazing woman. Thank you for all your hard work with the Puck Support Foundation. We have lots of work to do. You and I need to talk a little bit more, and we will in the coming weeks once everything settles down. I get moved into Morrisburg. Remember, if you're in the South Dundas area near Ottawa, come see us at the One Stop Skate Shop. Come hang out. Come say hi. Come get some unbelievable gear, man. Matt just got some sick stuff from the Ottawa Senators dressing room. Pro stock, like swag, gear, sticks, you name it. Wait till you see it. I'm getting up there Friday. I'll be back with Matt. Just want to give another shout out too to Matthew Lazinski and Mitch Fadden, the two that are closest to my heart that we've lost. And everything we do, guys, we do it for you. Maddie, I know you're looking down on Matt and I. You're making this so much easier for us, man. I know things weren't easy for you, but we're doing it for you now, brother. Mitch, we love you. All you guys, we love you. We miss you. We think of you often. To anybody struggling, you don't need to struggle. Reach out. Reach out for help. It's okay to not be okay. It's okay to not be okay. Just reach out. Ask for help. I know I did. I had to ask for help. And I recently had to ask for help too. I continually have to ask for help. Sometimes it's a shot to my ego. Sometimes it's embarrassing. Sometimes I just need help. And sometimes you may need help too. And I'm here to tell you that it's okay. That if you wanted to, and if you reach out and you change your attitude and you change your perspective, start doing the right things, good things will happen. Life will be good. Hope you guys are all having a great week. Happy hump day. thanks so much for joining me on episode one of Hockey to Hell and Back, the road to recovery. Look forward to seeing you guys on Saturday. Hopefully we'll have all the technical difficulties fixed up when Jacqueline Hawkins joins me, guys. We'll see you Saturday. And remember, have a great day if you so choose. Thank you.